Hi, this is Dr. Saxena, and as usual, we have been talking about some things, and during this pandemic, and now that we are hearing this is about the second wave and all that, I want every one of you should be well informed. You should try to understand what exactly you mean by biological terrain. What is that resistance power we used to talk about? I remember I used to see two kids, and one person, both of them eat ice cream, or both of them get drenched into in rain, and both are cousins or thing, but one person gets fever and cold, catches immediately after an ice cream or a drenched in the rainwater, the other person is not affected. So that made me inquisitive, wonder why is this? Both are of the same family, and one person is not getting a disease, is not having problems with simple issues. What is that helping him, this guy, out? And I just want you to also to understand that particular thing. Then we realize it is the resistance power of one kid is better. He is not having some. Again, we talk about, I don't want to get you into that typical medical words, what this is, TH1, TH2 and all that. I just want you to understand there is something concerned with the immune system, which is not regulated properly, which is causing all these problems. So very simple things I would like you to share with you, all you people, in case you get into some problem. Now we are talking about, everyone is talking about, on a TV, government authorities, schools are getting closed again. We are getting ready for this particular thing. We are talking about masks, everything we need to follow. We are talking about vaccine jabs, everyone has to. It's a very good effort by the government. And as a person, what you can work it out, how you can, what else you can do apart from using the sanitizer, apart from keeping a face mask up, apart from taking the jab, apart from taking, what are the other things what you can do? I just want to focus on that. In short, I just want you to prepare your immune system to work at the fastest and the most effective way. If your immune system is actively working, whatever may be the virus or whatever may be the infection you are exposed to, it is not going to harm you. For that, we need some things. We are talking about what are you going to do with the food, your lifestyle, what is things and all that. Just this is a simple things I would like to share. Your diet should be low in refined sugars, that is carbohydrate. No, don't go for refined carbohydrates, go for complex carbohydrates. Try not to take that white sugar at all during these days. Everyone is scared about that, boys, second wave and all that. The cases are rising, and we need to take care of ourselves. How you take care of ourselves? Try to shun. No refined sugars, no more sweets for you. Don't go for the processed meals. Whatever Swiggy is supplying you, it's okay sometimes, once in a week or something like that, but not in a usual kind of stuff. No pizzas, burgers and all that. I don't want to name things, you know about that. You need to eat more vegetables, you need to eat more fruits, and you need to eat more nuts. Nuts that too, you need to process it properly. You need to soak the nuts overnight and take the other day. That makes that's basically you are trying to make the food, the nuts which are soaked in water properly, they change to alkaline property, they are not acidic. And the germinating thing is the best particular thing. Other things what you can do, hydrate yourself well. Again, summer, you need to have, you should go for something. Good water intake. Good water intake. I have already told in other videos, look at your urine. If your urine color is dark, or if urine color is yellow, you are not properly hydrated. If you are properly hydrated, your urine color should be colorless. It should be clear. What are the other things you can do, but apart from whatever you are working on? You can do exercise at least 3 times a week. We try to talk about exercise in a big way, but somewhere if a person is walking around, if he is trying to do something like rebound exercises, which one of my favorite thing is a rebound exercise, because I don't find that kind of time, so I just do a rebound exercise. That makes it's a thing. Or you can always use your dumbbells and all that, try to work on that. The best thing what I tell everyone is try to go for a walk and move around. Don't sit in your sofa for a long time. The most important thing what I believe is sleeping for at least 8 hours a day. I was talking to one of a lot of people, they keep a call, and this is the reason the sleep is people, most of the people are deprived because of no fault of theirs. They don't know how to sleep properly. What are the things, what are the biohacks we need to work it out? You don't require any pills and all that. Certainly what you need is the cut off that light, try to switch off your Wi-Fi's and all that, and you can see, you can always have, take a proper nutrition, proper hydration, and you sleep like a baby. You need at least 8 hours sleep. If you sleep well, your immune system is absolutely working well. It's like recharge. And I believe a lot in something like music, reading a books, or something like meditation, which helps your immune system to tackle. So whatever what we have been talking about is trying to prepare your body, your biological, you have got your terrain, biological, make the terrain very firm so that whatever comes to you, it will hit you and go back. We call it as a kind of, you need to protect your biological terrain. And something which I have been always talking about, and I believe this is a food for thought again. You win a war by two ways. One is by smashing the enemy, and the other way you win is strengthening yourself, putting a kind of raksha kavach. Soldiers in the war, what they do, they just put a kind of steel frame or something like that, iron frame, so that is called kavach. And apart from that, they have the kind of forces, they have some bahubalis, they have some big strength. So whatever, any arrow also comes there, it strikes there and goes off. So in the same case, what I believe, when you are facing this pandemics and all that, you are out in a war. How you defend yourself? One is, okay, we are trying to smash off the enemy, taking a virus jab, we are trying to work it out, things, getting antiviral, getting all medicines and all. Apart from that, if you make yourself strong, that is half your battle is won. So I work on some things which I felt this should help people. It's a simple way of looking at things. I try to, in cases of people who are suspected, who doesn't have a history, you want to go for preventive kind of thing, I would like to ask them to take some multivitamins, I'd ask them to take some vitamin C. This is a tablet available over the counter, some vitamin D3 supplementation. zinc supplementation, try to ask them to take some selenium, good probiotics, something like melatonin. So these are the things which I would like people who are likely to get. So people looking at prevention, they have not got their problem, but everyone I think should make a note of this. These are few of the simple things which can help in a longer run, and you don't have to be so upset about that. Even if you get some kind of infection also, and if you follow this methodology work on that, it will help you in a big way. So this is my recommendations, and I hope I have made some points very clear. Better be safe and take care of all these things, and I'm sure you'll be able to manage this present pandemic without any much difficulties. Thank you.